coast. There could still be some of those tornadoes that Mike was just telling us about spinning up as we get through the morning. We're going to look at a lot of storm surge. We're going to see just flooding from rainfall and knocking down trees, creating power outages and causing travel problems too. Trees across the road in eastern North Carolina making travel very difficult as well. The storm has 90 miles per hour. It is moving northeast at 14. And every time I hear the alarm go off in the weather center, which is really often right now, I think that that's the National Hurricane Center saying, yes, officially, it's made landfall. And it is likely to be right here, if not right on Cape Lookout, maybe just a few miles improved on our sound side flooding as that storm moves on out of here. Closer to home, we have a flood watch in effect for a good portion of our viewing area, but a flood warning in effect from Roanoke Rapids through Tarboro, Rocky Mount, Smithfield, Goldsboro, and down toward Clinton. We are seeing flooding on the roads area. And, you know, it was years ago that we tended to see the greatest loss of life during a hurricane along the coast where we had the storm surge. People have gotten pretty smart along the coast and evacuated when officials told them to. So now that we have these heavy rains, people are thinking, oh, you know, the hurricane's on the coast. Not such a big deal here. That is not the flooding that is happening. And during Floyd, we all remember that flooding, and I'm not saying this is going to be anything like Floyd, but during Floyd, most people who died during the storm died because they drove their car into a flooded road. So we really stress east of the Triangle area, this is a good time to just stay put, let these waters recede for a while because it is very dangerous out there. We have the work still in effect for the entire coastline. Along with flooding, we're seeing problems with trees. We have a high wind warning in effect along the I-95 corridor for gusts up to 60 miles per hour, tapering that off a bit as we head across the central part of our triangle area, gusts up to 50 miles per hour. Still expecting a lot of rain, about 2 inches in the triangle, 3 to 5 along the I-95. So rain induced flooding, a problem, trees down, power outages, travel really becoming fairly dicey along I-95, the I-95 corridor in our viewing area. But things are going to improve late this afternoon and overnight tonight. We're back to sunshine on Sunday.
All right, so getting through it. Just don't know what's on the other side. All right, thanks, Elizabeth.